We got action, folks. There's a one lost side finals. The winner of this match plays the Dominguez kid in the finals. And we'll see what happens. Vilmos Valdez with the winner of the flip. Giving up two games on the wire to nine. Alright. Here we go, folks. Vilmos to break him off. And
he's breaking pretty good, Vilmos.
Yeah. Joining us in the booth is Pops.
Hi, everybody.
Alright, see how Vilmos is breaking. See if you don't jinx him dead. He is breaking good, but the corner ball's not going. It's going high. But he slopped in another ball. Two ball looks like it's going to tie up with a three. He's jacked up over the one.
I don't think he can make it one.
No, I don't think so either. If he does make it, it barely passes. But even if he makes it, there's no reward. You know, if you look at this camera angle.
Yes.
Yeah, I mean, but I don't think the two ball passes.
He got to play three rails, is what he's going to do. Three safe.
What's safe? Wow.
He don't know how the safe is.
Yeah, he doesn't know what safe is. He's playing ring game rules. Boom, boom, boom.
I stopped the board right there. But
yeah, of course.
Send that to the five. The five.
Yeah.
The five got to stop you.
Plus, you block off that other side of the table, too.
Yeah, me, but they got to go for the shot. Oh, no, he did what I said.
So what is this? Played safe.
Come on, dude.
What's going on here?
Something is wrong.
I always tell people, the old Vilmos Valdez, when he was younger, when we knew him in the Philippines, he, at the World Championships, I mean, he never, ever played safe.
Nah, he went for everything.
Yeah. I mean, literally, he never played safe. And
but he fucked everything.
Yeah, I mean, he was playing world class back then when he was just a junior and just running dead out from everywhere. And he had to play safe when it was super obvious. Even then, he'd think about running out.
Now he's...
You know, this Campos guy plays pretty good.
Oh, yeah, he's not a...
It's not a regular 7, he's a super 7.
Probably 8.
Yeah, he's close to an 8. He actually gambles even with Skip, I just found out.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, he plays gambles dead even with Skip. Skip wins, but still. I mean, he's one of those borderline players. You're always going to have a borderline player. And you can't really... The guy's played in 4 of our events. He's never done good. He's got 9th through 12th or 7th, 8th one time. I mean... I think the guy deserves to do good.
Yeah.
You know, how am I going to punch the guy if he does good one term and put him as an 8 right away?
No.
The idea is for 7s to do well. That's why that's the point of the handicap. Nice hit. Good separation between the 2 ball and the cue ball. And he left Daniel a shot, but on the good side for Vilmos is that he left it frozen on the rail. And if he does make it, it's automatic to bump that 9 or come really close to bumping that 9.
Well, he can stroke the ball a little bit and try to bump the 8.
Oh, right? Yeah, that'd be a good shot.
But as soon as you elevate the cue, now it's more complicated to make it.
Yeah, this is the hard part here.
Yeah.
And a big shout out to our friend Dave Martinow. Dave Martinow from San Diego.
Oh, okay.
Alright, we got a tough shot here by, you know, he shot it the way you said, kind of spear into it a little bit, and, he controlled the cue ball well, but he missed the ball.
Well, the 3 don't pass the 8,
Yes,
yeah,
he does.
Yeah.
Here, I like just rolling it, not even trying to stroke it, just roll it, and leave yourself guaranteed that you don't hook yourself on that 5. Oh. He hit it really thick and made it easily, so it must have been straighter than I thought. Okay, so Vilmos has the option to shoot it in the lower left-hand corner, or upper left-hand corner, excuse me, which was the right shot. Well, too straight. That was a bad mistake by Vilmos. I think he, considering how close he was to the 3 ball, he should have gotten a little bit better angle.
Yeah, but
now he's gonna have to punch forward and cut the six and go up and down.
I think he has to throw the ball and then leave himself for the back or tough cut. I don't know. He got three or four options to do it.
I think he can punch follow, just a little bit, like follow it like 1 foot, and then just cut
and
the
take,
six.
Take the top shot.
Yeah,
for the six.
Yeah, I like that shot because if you try drawing it, you're kind of jacked up queuing over the eight.
And when you're trying to cut in the side pocket, he's looking at that.
He's gonna put inside English four cushions and cut it in the side.
Yeah.
He's a big scratch in the side pocket here on the fourth cushion. Big scratch. Big scratch. And he hit it very well. He didn't. He barely missed the point on the other, the titty on the other side pocket, so he hit it. He's still in tough position. He made a great shot, and he's still in tough position. You know, these pockets play so tight whenever you hit them with any speed.
Yeah,
you
tell
have to,
me about it.
Ultra smooth stroke
it. I made a lot of shots.
Yeah.
Barely touch the rail and don't go.
Yeah, this shot is very pure delivery, you have to give it. And he hit it pure.
It's still not easy.
He's still not easy. Now it's almost nice to play short side position on the eight. That way you don't have to put inside English, just put like a high ball or one tip of running English to the left. Just like he did there. Oh, he put inside.
Yeah.
Wow. Wow, what a pretty shot.
Yeah.
Good shot, almost.
Oh, this tension.
Yeah, he can't reach. Oh. Yeah, just roll it in. And roll it in. I'll stake you here, Dad.
Yeah.
You stake me?
No.
Thanks.
No. Maybe you missed you.
Yeah, I know. I dog it. All right, 2-1 favor Vilmos Valdez after a after a miss by Campos. That 2-ball miss.
Well, yeah.
Tough shot.
Was makeable, but you know,
it was makeable, yeah.
It's breaking with his own cue or what? No,
he's been breaking from the edge of the break box. I have no idea why, but I think
he's working.
It's working. He's making a ball. He's like catching the 8-ball off the bottom rail. Let's pay attention to that 8-ball on the bottom rail. He gets kicked into opposite corners. Oh, the 8-ball was bounced off, but didn't get kicked in this time. Oh, good results. I mean, good break. But
the one ball passes.
The 1-ball passes a 3.
You think so?
Yeah, look at the camera here.
Oh, the camera, you know.
Definitely tells us. Yeah, the 1-ball definitely passes, 100%. I agree, Clay. It is an interesting spot to break from. It's like, it's almost like a wannabe 10-ball break, but without the squat. He must be seeing something that we don't. But he's making a ball consistently. He just hasn't seen the one very well.
Wow, nice shot that one.
Nice shot.
He's a straight shooter.
He's a straight shooter.
Probably I go underneath the six, even to try to bump the six from there, in that situation.
Oh, you mean from position from the 3 to the 5?
Yeah.
Like, basically play the 5 and bump the 6. What about stopping the cue ball there after making the 2, rolling up on the 3, stopping the 3 ball, and kind of laying straight in to draw the cue ball long? Or go on this side of the table and go 4 cushions behind it.
not a way you
there's a lot of ways. Now. I mean, really, there's...
You can leave the keyboard where it is right now and cut this six and...
That's true.
You know, you
if
don't
you're
have
really
to
feeling go touch to anything, yeah.
Touch anything, you know. But it depends how you feel. This is a weird part about this game, you know. Yeah. Sometimes you say, oh, the only thing I have to do is go this way, that way, and then you make a mistake.
Yeah. Daniel's here using that middle extension, the balance right, and between his key. I mean, he's about 6 foot one, 6 foot two.
Oh, he needs extension.
He needs the extension. He's got really long wingspan.
Yeah.
He's about 6'2". So let's see what Mr. Campos does here.
Almost.
Now, I think he made a mistake here.
Not really.
Just because I feel like it's too thin of a cut and the scratch in the side's big.
No, you don't have to hit it. You don't have to put it the English mid.
You want to just play position for the corner?
Play natural angle, you avoid this nine ball and bounce, and then bounce where this even...
Center table.
Yeah, exactly.
Oh, okay, so you're talking about playing position to cut the ball.
Yeah, or you can run in English and...
And bump the eight ball from
behind. And the eight, you know, or bump the six.
I like that.
In case you don't miss
you
eight.
Just want to make sure you don't spin it too much and hit the seven.
Oh yeah.
That's huge.
And then,
you
then
hit
you
the seven, you're
dead.
You unless you hit it full.
Or don't spin it up and then you go straight to the scratch. And
exactly.
Up, you know?
Yeah. So it's a delicate shot. That's why I didn't like it.
No.
I would have drew it a little bit on the three ball because he could have.
He's doing the
shot you're saying originally, which is center table position to cut the six in. Oh no, he spun it. He hit it well.
Yeah,
and
if
not,
he don't hit the egg, he want to hit the nine or six. Soft. Side pocket, both ball.
Tough shot here.
Yeah.
Not easy at all.
No, it's like medium speed, that way the ball bounces off the rail, the toe rail.
These shots are doggable. Tell me about it.
Yeah. Yeah, you miss that shot.
I know. It's so easy. But it's just doggable. It's hard to see the angle. A little too firm. But it's manageable. You have the option to put high inside or spear into it a little bit and go three cushions around the nine ball.
I know English and bounce almost where she is right now, a little bit. Like 6 inches not a foot away from the rail.
Yeah. Well, I mean, he is hitting the seven fairly thin, so you're right. Just don't leave yourself jacked up on the nine if you do that.
Oh! What the hell was that?
You're not supposed to hit it flat. You're supposed to jack up if you're going to go three cushions. He hit it very, very ugly hit.
Well, because sometimes the shaft... You hit it hard and
deflects
more than what you expect, and and sometimes you look like that. But he got lucky because he no sold out nothing, you know.
Well, he didn't sell out, but he left.
No, not really. That shot is tough.
Oh, I know, but I'm saying I think Vilmos is gonna double bank it down table, or go for the win, cross corner. Maybe he's
I think he go cross.
He's
corner.
From Louisville, Hungary.
To try to cut it look like.
I don't know what he's gonna do. What a pretty shot, huh?
Wow.
What a pretty shot that was. Even though he didn't get a great position, I know what he was thinking. Just to get down table, so in case you miss it.
He hit it so good.
Yeah, he hit it really good.
That's why he no got position.
I'm just worried about making the ball.
Well, yeah, sometimes it's that situation you have to worry about for making the ball.
But here's a good shot, Dad. Bank it to the center diamond, hit about the first and a half diamond between the second diamond, and put the
cue
ball.
The nine.
Yeah, put the cue ball, put the A ball behind the nine and stop the cue ball there.
Oh, roll it. And put it in the short rail, like that.
Oh, that's a better shot.
Yeah.
And you guarantee yourself the cue ball.
I'm sure.
You know, Daniel Campos made a real good shot on me, like the first game. I left him almost frozen, and he fired a ball in and just ran out.
right now, he go for the chart and then hit the nine, and maybe something good happened. No, I don't think he can scratch. If he hit the nine, no way he can scratch. The only way he can scratch if it's real, if he hit real 10 the nine more.
No, he's looking at the combination.
Oh, well, I don't know that, you know. He go for the
one. No, you're not. I don't think you go for the combination here, because if you hit it a little fat, you're dead in the drink.
Yeah.
He almost ran the drink. This is a shot. Just, you might even hit it a little bit on the fat side and play safe. Like a one pocket speed. No, too hard. Too hard. You know what speed I'm talking about, right? Hit it on the fat side and leave him a bank. And maybe the nine ball blocks everything.
Well, he did the right thing, but he missed the ball.
Yeah, he missed it. It almost has a tough shot on the side.
No, it's pretty straight. But then,
queuing off the rail is not that easy, but he hit it good.
Yeah.
Perfect position. Center ball, and you're in business.
Yeah.
All right, 2-2.
No more handicap.
Yeah, playing even now.
But that's it. 2-2-2.
Got a Backstreet Boys hour here.
Who?
Backstreet Boys of music. Oh. Someone's playing Backstreet Boys here. Alright, almost to break him. One ball on the side he's been making. See if he continues it. Oh, hit the outside point. And
no shot.
In jail, I think. Yeah.
Oh, it's, you know,
oh,
try
break.
Oh, he's lucky because he didn't leave any shot. Not even a push out.
Not even a good push out. He's in jail.
No, but he can.
I know what I do here.
You hook yourself and jump it. I know that. Crazy.
No, well, I push out on the long rail just so I can accurately cue, reach the jump shot. He's going to pass it back to me, and I jump bank the one ball up table. And I use the 8, 6, 2, 5, 9 of blockers. You understand?
Yeah.
So just push it to the long rail and just bank it down table and stop the cue ball. It's not that tough.
Yeah, for you, because it's not tough, but not everybody thinks that. I think I shoot the three ball soft pull there.
And push out there.
Yeah, block at the bank, you know.
Yeah, but you don't think he's going to put you in jail there behind the nine?
Well, you know, it's okay.
You'll figure it out from there.
Yeah. And maybe he'll hook you. I don't know. Sometimes you think they got to hook you and they don't hook you.
That's true.
Or they hook you easy, you know, and you escape.
So that, we're going to buy our tickets for Turning Stone. Someone's asking if we're going to Turning Stone. Yeah. Lynn, we are going to Turning Stone.
Yeah.
Going to wait for Cyber Monday to buy our tickets. Tomorrow.
What is he doing?
I have no idea what he's doing. Is he kicking it?
I don't know.
No, he can't be kicking it. Are you serious?
No, he knows more than us. I never tried that shot because I don't know.
I can't believe what just happened.
Well, you know, you cannot see the push out.
I can't believe he did that. That's unbelievable.
Or maybe he don't know he can push out. I don't know. Maybe
he doesn't know he can push out.
I don't know.
They're playing ring game rules, dude.
I don't know. Some people, you know, you get...
You forget. You're so focused, you forget. Yeah,
especially when you don't play that many tournaments, you know.
It's true. I've seen that happen before.
I know. It happens to me before, you know. I forget them.
Oh, what a shot. What a shot. No, perfect.
Wow. Now what?
Good shot.
Now what?
Now he's in trouble. Now he's got to kick one rail, long rail, with spin. Right before the side pocket. Maybe even it's just one tip of running English. He's got a generous angle.
Yeah, maybe he made the same. What are you going to do? He can see it?
No. No, no, we cannot see this.
Oh. Well, different angles. We got, we're sitting over here in different computer angle. You know, sometimes you see it.
Yeah, he's got a kick.
We have to put the camera in the top, that way we can see all
the
angles.
Yeah, that'd be sweet. Get like a GoPro and put it on top of the light.
Yeah.
That'd be sweet. I actually saw a deal on GoPros on Black Friday.
Yeah.
And it should be Cyber Monday still. You know, that's a good idea.
That way...
Oh my god, he jumped the edge of the too, and he... And here comes a nine ball. No. They sold out.
Not really, you know. That shot is
kind of
wild. Well, they sold out the one, but the position for the two is not like.
Yeah, he might have to go for the 2-9.
Yeah, 2-9 or.
It's a five ball. It's tied up.
And the two to the three is not that
easy.
Easy.
Yeah, you gotta get perfect on it.
Maybe go for the combination of the nine. Is the way you say. And the same time you put the cue ball in that, put it behind the 5 and 6.
Mm-hmm.
But we go to see what he does. Yeah. He screwed up.
He screwed up big time.
What? You go to bank it or what?
Not sure.
He's in good position to bank the ball.
Yeah, and he might even rub the nine ball here. Patada y mordida.
Yeah, well.
Oh, cut it. Frozen, no good. Bad result here.
No, he's okay.
Think so?
Yeah.
This is four ball
pass. It's not easy.
It's not easy.
It's not easy. I think the four don't pass the seven, or will it pass the seven?
Jeez, well, he got away with it.
Not really. No, he got to be behind the nine, probably, right? I think he can see it, right?
Yeah, I think so.
He got to bank the three ball in the middle of the table and put it behind the nine, right? Or behind the six and five and eight. Either way, he got a lot of balls to hook it.
Yeah, absolutely.
The only way he no hook it if he hit the five ball when he banked the ball.
In the turning stone.
Why?
Por su... Eso es lo que soy pronto, yeah.
Comportamiento,
yeah. Okay. Well, what happened? Did you almost take a bathroom break?
I don't know, he went.
Oh, there he is. Jump time.
No, he got to kick.
He's kicking two cushions, maybe playing in the side.
Yeah, from behind.
Yeah. Oh, he crossed it. Oh, wow. Well struck shot by Mr. Foldis. Now, I'm sure you like this shot too. It's hitting about a quarter ball.
And got three rails.
Three cushions behind the 9-8,
yeah.
6-5. I mean, that's the obvious shot. Other than that, I mean...
Because no way he can scratch. It looks like the five ball is in the way, in case he comes straight to the pocket. And that's an obvious shot, you know. Well, because maybe he don't play three cushion. You know? I think he ought to do that.
No, he does.
It looks like he's trying to make it or something, you know. I don't know.
Curious as to what he's going to do here.
No, he's supposed to do that shot, but if he don't do it, that's because we don't know that much in them.
Oh, he thinned it too much. He hit it poorly. He kind of got lucky there.
You don't even try to do what we say, you know?
Yeah. Oh, he just hit it too thin. He was trying that.
Maybe he tried that?
Yeah, I think so.
No. Two rails behind the nine.
I guess he's just gonna bank it and send the cue ball two cushions into the 9-6.
Yeah,
I'm good, thank you.
It's another shot at the billiards, you know.
Yeah, he never really committed to anything.
No, definitely.
Now the 6-ball passes. Now the only question is the 8-ball. But considering the position of the 7-ball, he can go 3 cushions into the 8, short side. There's a lot of options. But here, this is a tough
shot. I don't think
shot.
He can make it.
Oh, you're right. He is hooked.
The 8-ball is in the way. He's looking at that. You know, I don't think he can see it. A full ball. Maybe he can see part of the ball. That's what he's trying to figure out about. Because if he cannot make it, then he has to do something different now.
Yeah, I made the top 5. I made my 3.
Yep.
All right, well, it's kicking.
I don't know what he's doing. Maybe he can see some of the ball.
Oh, yeah.
But he cannot make it, probably. Probably he got to bank the ball like just barely past the side pocket, and then put the cue ball behind the 7.
Right, right.
Yeah, I think it's what the shot he got to do it, but it's hard to see it from here.
Yeah. See? Oh, beautiful shot.
No, no.
He gets half credit.
He can pre-stroke the shot, you know, it's not jacked up enough. But it's not easy, it's far away the shot.
Yeah.
But this guy is a straight shooter. Yeah. So far he's making all the tough shots.
He's made almost every tough shot.
Yeah. I like about him because he tried real hard.
He does put a lot of heart into
it.
He's
probably
not the most talented individual as far as, but he makes up for it in pure determination.
Yeah.
And that's always a good thing.
Real hard, you know, and I respect
him. Wants to win.
He wants to win.
He's a competitor.
Exactly.
And that's respectable. I mean, it's a beautiful thing. You know, if a lot of top players had his determination.
Like him,
there'd be a lot of.
But it'll be real tough for us to come in the money.
Yeah. Can you imagine, like, a guy who doesn't miss, like, a very talented player who has that determination?
Jeez.
Unstoppable.
She just passes
right through. And we have it like seated chairs sealing it off and they still don't figure it out.
Double bank?
That's a good shot.
I don't know.
Z bank, one pocket shot. Now that's a good shot.
Not really. I think he screwed up already. No.
Oh, Dad.
That's
perfect.
Okay.
He's got the Great Wall of China. Great Wall of Hungary there.
Yeah, that's true.
Now he's in trouble.
Not really. Before the side pocket.
Yeah.
With a lot of English. And get it 3 rails. From behind. He can go between the... You see, from here you cannot see it, you know?
Could he really see that ball?
That's what I say, you know.
Wow, that's amazing if he got window shopping right here.
Yeah, I see. I don't know, it's look like me, it's black, but I don't know. It's just tough to from here to see it. And the street, the screen, you know, see.
I don't think it goes, Dad. I really don't think it does. I'll be shocked if it goes. Wow. That's blind. Unbelievable. Vilmos is shaking his head. He can't believe that he even saw it. So, by Vilmos shaking his head, we all know that that was all he had, literally. That was all he could see, and that was just enough to make the ball. And considering his position on that shot, I mean, he did pretty good with it. He got the cue ball up table. He's got a shot to win. You know, he missed it, but he shot to win.
It's not over yet. Probably the 8-ball goal. Maybe the 8-ball goal.
I don't think it does, but if it doesn't, then now's the time to move it, to move the 9.
No, he didn't even try, and then the 8-ball goal.
It must go. Oh, it must go. Yeah, easily then. Yeah, he just very nonchalantly played position there, so it's got to be obvious for him. Got 3 consecutive games by Vilmos Foldis. If he makes this 9, like so. So score reads 3-2, but in actuality it is 3-0. But with the 2-game handicap, Mr. Campos is still in the fight.
Yep.
See how Daniel breaks him now. He's been breaking dry. He's been slopping a ball in into the side pocket. Like, seems like the 6 and the 7 seem to be banking. Let's see if, see if my guesswork is on point here. Because I remember him catching the 4 ball here, which is the ball behind the 8, which is a corner ball. Let's see what happens. I don't see why. I'm trying to figure out why he continues to break from there, but. Wow, he almost caught the corner ball there. See, the 6 ball almost banged cross side.
But he keep breaking dry, and he keep breaking from the same spot. That's why I don't understand, you know?
Yeah, that's why. That's exactly what I'm thinking. And if he doesn't break dry and he makes a ball, he's getting lucky to make a ball. In this situation, you're not going to beat Vilmos in a safety battle. Normally.
He's hooked.
Yeah, I know, but I'm saying it's like, if it's a slow game.
The only problem with that shot, maybe he can scratch in the side pocket to try to hit it that way, you know?
Oh, yeah.
With the kiss of the 8.
Yeah, I see it. I see what you're saying.
Because he tried to run away from that.
Oh, he hit a soft. But he hooked. He's hooked.
Yes, if he hit it hard, you see this, the camera
goes
right
direct. Right on the side, you're right.
If I was shooting that shot to make it, I have to shoot it harder. That way I can make position with no reason to make it then. Well, the coin is in the air.
Yeah, well, I mean, it's so early.
He can still defend himself, but not because he cashed him already with the spot. It means he already lost, no. He tried real hard to do good. He got it. He missed a couple shots, but that was tough. It wasn't easy at all, you know. Another tough shot, look at it. he's doing. Two behind it, before the side pocket?
No, I don't think so. Oh, yeah. No. Foul.
Yeah.
I think Daniel's starting to, starting to get a little bit weaker now as far as decision making.
No, that one, he's trying, wasn't in jail, it was tough for him to hit it. We got to see Vilmos run out here.
Yeah, this is a little weak, but he's perfect.
No, not really. Oh, the four ball is in the middle. Side pocket. Okay, that's good. No
problem. You're going to draw it over, that way you can follow the four ball, three cushions.
No, he got to follow the ball, soft in his move. Come straight.
You think so?
Yeah. I think he got to follow the ball.
I think he's going to pinch it.
Yeah, you think so?
Yeah, just because he likes to do that pinch stroke. He always does it. Yeah, that pinch stroke. See, now you can follow three cushions. Natural position. Now all he has to do is not end up straight on the five, and he's good position.
And what are you going to do?
He's going to end up straight on the five. Of course he is. And frozen. Perfect. Now he's got to draw it precision for the side pocket, because I don't think the six goes in the corner between the 7-8.
He does, but
he's going to cheat it. He's going to cheat it a little bit.
Perfect.
Making quick work of it, making the game look a little easy here. Comes across the line. Not the best of positions, but
it's okay.
A shot maker like Vilmos should handle this situation. To break. Vilmos is what in the world is Vilmos doing?
He's breaking for the guy, he's not making ball?
He's breaking 10 ball. He's gonna smash the living daylights out of him. What do we know? Caught the corner ball. And got perfect. Vilmos is laughing.
Yeah, he's laughing because he set it up pretty good.
Yeah, because he knows that he normally shouldn't do that, but he's doing it and it's working. All right, so now Vilmos has quite the interesting situation. He can elect to roll it, leave himself a little distance, and cinch, guarantee himself a shot at the three.
That's what he went to do.
Or he can try to get cute and draw it around the six.
No, he goes to shoot off.
I think so too. That's the shot. You want to guarantee yourself a nice angle.
No, because you got stroking the ball a little bit and the five ball in the side pocket.
Yeah.
Even if he hit the eight, it's still.
You're still manageable. It's still,
yeah. But,
I like his selection, obviously. And I think Vilmos is a heavy favorite to get good position on this. Hit it very well. Actually hit it perfect. And you can roll his ball and just stop it there for the six in the corner. And possibly shooting the six
ball.
Well,
he got two options. To stroke it and or roll it.
Yeah. He's going to shoot the seven in the same pocket, I'm assuming. Oh.
Yeah.
Stunt. Nice shot.
Yeah.
Good control. And the overhand position.
He's right in the middle.
Yeah. He's definitely wanted to play position for the corner. But luckily for Vilmos is that he can hit a high outside angle, just like a natural roll. I mean, now you just have to focus on making it. Put one tip of outside or two tips of outside, just a nice, good speed. Yeah, that's a nice shot.
No way.
No way. That's not a nice shot, actually.
It's not.
So now he's got to.
They
don't
say
kick it, Vilmos. Don't do that.
Well, if you feel like do it, why not? Let him do it.
God.
Don't coach him.
No, I'm not coaching. He's a big boy. He knows how to do it. I just think it'd be kind of suicidal to kick.
No, you got to play safe.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah. You got to leave the bank straight in. Look at it. Bank straight in. Watch it.
No, Dad, it's not straight in.
No, I'm telling you.
Look at that angle. I mean, he's got to hit the ball real well.
Yeah.
I think he's going to, I agree. I think he's going to gin it.
Yeah.
Because he's got nothing to lose here. It's a free shot. He shouldn't even be at the table.
That's right.
I agree 100%. I think he's going to make it.
Yeah.
I think he's going to split the wicket.
Yeah, it's pretty hard to play safe from there. Maybe you kick it from behind. Like,
no.
But he go for the bank. You know.
Yeah, he's going for the bank. Not much else besides a sellout or winning is going to happen here. Hard to really play a good save. He ginned it. Oof.
Oh, yeah, at least he tried.
Yeah, he tried. He shoots away. What else can you do?
Yeah.
A situation like that, I mean, you're the underdog no matter what. Especially when the table plays tough like that, you know, tight pockets.
Mm-hmm.
So it is 5-2 favor of Vilmos Foldes. And he's running away with the match, Dad.
We don't know yet.
I mean, he's 5 in a row.
He was like that before.
Yeah, that's right. The guy came back.
And the guy came back and beat him, you know.
After this match is the finals, but more importantly for the spectators and the fans who are here, the raffle, the key raffle. It's Oh, by the way, I'm sorry, I've been a little bit laggy on the sponsor. James Hanshew Custom Jump Cues. He cut the cup break up.
Yeah.
And not an easy shot, but it is a shot.
In the corner?
Yeah. It's not easy, but it's a shot. But the four ball kind of plays the sideboard there if he overcuts it. But I mean, you don't even want to use those sideboards. You want to try and make it. Don't even worry about playing the overcuts. You just try to make it. If he does not elect to do that, I don't see a real obvious safety other than, well, quite honestly, I don't see an obvious safety. It's a peculiar position because I don't like it. I don't like what's going on. I don't think
you cannot see the angle. That's why this is
a very difficult shot.
Because no position.
Yeah, exactly. It's like no reward to making a tough shot. And quite honestly, missing that shot is probably the best thing that could have happened to him. Missing it like that would have...
Well, right now you had the two rails, high English, maybe nick the nine in the corner. If not, the one ball go downhill.
Yeah.
And you control the white ball, follow the ball. Like one pocket shot, you know, but right now you have to hit it hard.
Yeah, it's
I don't try to make that one.
Me neither. I bank it four cushions.
No, I tried to make the knife on there. Two rails and then thinner. If not, I send it.
That's one an interesting
board,
shot.
Three balls, three rails down.
That's an interesting shot.
And you use high English, maybe you put it behind the eight, you know.
I like that shot.
Maybe I do that, you know, if I was playing. I don't think I tried to make the one.
Well, let's see what he sees. Obviously, once you're at the table, it's always a little bit different. And he shot the four rails.
Is that torn?
Yeah, which is...
I told you.
I like that shot. I liked it a lot.
Not...
He hit it very controlled. The cue ball, very high control.
That's what I said, you know, behind the eight, you see?
Yeah,
he almost needed the nine ball.
Yeah, he almost made it.
Almost made it, yeah. I cannot execute, but I can still see it. Oh, he's jumping with the normal cue.
Wow, and spirited. And we got a bad roll there. That's a pretty bad roll. Now he's got a kick and hope.
Oh yeah, well, you know, got control right there. No. How you got to control nothing, you know? It's in the middle of the table. It's pretty hard to even to try to kick it. You know, it's easy to kick, but you know, to play safe and but the whole idea is over here. You have to kick it.
Yeah.
And hoping for the best, you know.
So we got a rematch here of the earlier match, and I believe Vilmos won Hill-Hill. Campos won Hill-Hill, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay.
And
well, he was in the same situation. He was losing
down,
that way.
Yeah. And then he just
came
back.
And then he came back, you know.
So now we got a... Campos is a nifty little thinker here.
But luck in the seven is good.
Nifty shot, my friend. I don't think he even realized what a great shot he just did.
Well, you know, he's got the options, you know, he can...
Because, I mean, think about it. The odds of you winning at that position are like 0%. Now with this situation that he did, it went up to like 25%, 30%. He's still at a disadvantage.
Well,
but
right now, the only thing he has to do, like...
he might shoot again.
Yes, but that shot, Vilmos have it, you know.
Play shape for the
I shoot another way. I send that two ball for the nineness and put it behind the five. I don't try to run out.
He's gonna run out.
No.
I like shooting to run out too.
I
like just follow forward.
I don't think it's a good idea to try to run out.
I like this shot. Just because you're coming away, you're gonna bounce off of it because the angle you're coming at. He hit the high side.
I think he screwed up already. In my mind. I don't know.
I think he hit the high side of the nine and he's good.
I know.
He touched it, I think.
No, he not touched nothing.
No.
He missed the whole ball.
Now he's screwed.
No. Now he can use the nine ball to make the corner and then open up.
Oh, well, that's...
You know, it's another shot.
That's super tough, though, Dad.
Not really.
You're mad at your money, shouldn't
you? It's a straight aim, hijito. What is it with you? It's a straight aim, I'm telling you.
I don't know, Dad. I could never shoot it.
Well,
oh, you mean shoot the nine off the seven into it, like a double ticky?
Yeah.
No, well, I understand what you're saying, but I just...
Oh, I shoot the five to the nine, and then
I mean, you
open up.
Open, being up five to two, you can shoot
if
this.
You miss it, well, you lose.
You shoot this hill?
I think so, why not? If I want to win.
Why not?
Yeah.
That's why you're nuts.
Well, what are you to play safe? Where? Tell me.
I play survival.
But where?
Well, say you cut the five in the side and send the cue ball on the left-hand long rail and pin the seven, the nine ball holds you and send the cue ball towards the eight.
I think you're losing your money. You know what to win that way. This way, if you hit the nine...
Yeah, but... Okay. I want to see what Vilmos does. I'm willing to bet you...
You know what to do that?
I'm willing to bet you...
I'm crazy or what?
I think you're a little crazy. I'm willing to bet you a bottle of water that he does not shoot the shot you said. That's all I'm going
to
say.
Okay, well, I think you got to lose a bottle of water.
Oh, God, you got action. You got action, my friend.
If Fino shoots that shot, he got to lose. Put it that way.
Okay. I'm not going to... Oh, my. Well, he's going to lose right here anyways. Here. Oh, Jesus. What in the hell was that?
I don't know. I like that shot. My chance is
better. You know what? From that position, shooting that shot, your shot, I shoot your shot, 100%.
Okay, well.
I agree 100% with you there, but you still owe me a bottle of water.
Uh-oh.
It's perfect.
Perfect. Oy. Almost he got the spread.
Oh, he hit that ball too thin.
Yeah.
Now, the only thing that's kind of helping Campos...
Scratch in the corner?
No. What I was going to say, the only thing that's helping him is that the 9 ball, if he hits it a little thick, can bump the 7 in the corner, cutting it.
Nah, if he don't cut it from the beginning, he don't got to make it. He have to tend the ball right with a rail first.
He's got to hit a real good shot here. Very difficult shot.
Yeah, at least.
Spin.
French ball.
He spun it. Now he hit it.
No, but goodbye.
Very good. Goodbye. How? Oh. Vilmos. Wow, this game's huge, too. From 5-3 to 6-2. Big gap.
Yeah.
Of course.
Yeah. Just like that, Vilmos is okay, I guess. Yeah, he's perfect.
Yeah, it's okay.
Drag draw with inside, just like that. Nice shot. Good control. And now we have Mr. Fold as Zephyr deposits this one 6-3, or 6-2, excuse me. Let's give a big shout out to the official cloth sponsor. Oh boy. What am I doing here?
Yes, yes.
Wirecast is not responding. If you guys freeze up, I'm sorry. Froze up.
Oh yeah?
Izzy, Wirecast just froze up.
Not responding.
Okay. Calm down. You might respond.
Did I freeze the stream?
Yes.